What I want to do in this video is try to understand how one company can buy another company or could merge it with another company by using its stock. So we have a situation here where company A is acquiring company B for $60 million in A's shares. And what we'll see is it's not going to exactly be $60 million. It'll depend on where company A's shares trade. Right now, they're trading at $30 a share. So in order to make this transaction happen in A shares, what would happen is that A says, look, I need to raise the equivalent of $60 million in shares, or I need to create the equivalent of $60 million in shares. If each of my shares right now on the market are worth $30 a share, then I can do that by creating or issuing 2 million shares. So company A here is going to create another 2 million shares. They're going to create another 2 million shares. And if they wanted to do it as a cash transaction, they could take these shares and sell them into the market, do a secondary offering, and then hopefully raise $60 million in cash, and then use that cash to buy company B. But this is a share offering. They're not going to do it with cash. They're going to directly give, assuming company B shareholders agree to this, they're going to give the shares directly to company B's shareholders in exchange for essentially getting control of these shares right over here. So they're going to take these 2 million shares, which right now in the market look to be worth $60 million, and they're going to give them to all of company B's shareholders in exchange for all of company B's existing shares. So what's going to happen is company A is going to give 2 million shares of company A to the shareholders of company B, and in exchange, company B will give all of the shareholders of company B will give their shares to company A. So they will give, or their shares of company B, I should say. Company B's shareholders are going to give all of their 1 million shares in company B in exchange for those 2 million of company A. So what's going to happen is each of these shareholders of company B are going to get 2 shares of company A for every 1 share of company B. So they're going to get two shares of A for every share of B they own. And that makes sense economically, because right now on the market, let's say that it's trading at $50 a share. It has a $50 million market cap. By offering a $60 million in share, they're offering a premium. This is what would kind of convince all of their shareholders to maybe say, hey, this is a pretty good deal. I'm getting 20% above the market price. And when you get 2 shares in exchange for your one $50 share, you're getting 2 shares that are right now trading at $30 a share. So it seems like a good deal for you. I can exchange something worth $50 for 2 things worth $30, or essentially exchange something worth $50 for something worth $60. I'm going to take it. And if they do take it, then what's essentially going to happen is that those 1 million shares are going to be put onto the asset side of company A's balance sheet, or maybe we could just put that company B is now here, because all of their shares are here. It's not completely owned. And the company was able to do that by issuing these shares. The other option, they could have sold those shares in the market, raised $60 million, then given the $60 million directly to the company B shareholders, and then it would have had the exact same effect.